far end of town where the grickle grass grows, and the wind smells slow and sour when it blows, and no birds ever sing excepting old crows, is the street of the lifted Lorax. Grickle grass, grickle grass, street of the lifted Lorax. Grickle grass, grickle grass, somebody lifted the Lorax away.
What was the Lorax? And why was it there? And why was it lifted and taken somewhere from the far end of town where the grickle grass grows? The old Onceler still lives here. Ask him. He knows. You won't see the Onceler. Don't knock at his door. He lurks in his lurkum on top of his store. And on grickly midnights in August, he peeks out of the shutters, and sometimes he speaks and tells how the Lorax was lifted away.
It all started way back, such a long, long time back. Way back in the days when the grass was still green, and the pond was still wet, and the clouds were still clean, and the song of the Swami Swans rang out in space. One morning I came to this glorious place. Then I saw the trees, the truffula trees, the bright colored tufts of the truffula trees, mile after mile in the fresh morning breeze. And under the trees I saw brown barbaloots frisking about in their barbaloots.
Under the trees, happy dappy barbaloots, under the trees, in our barbaloot suits. Under the trees, eating truffula fruits,
boldly succulent,
mellifluous,
deliciously
mellifluous,
sweetly succulent-fluous,
truffula fruits. Salmon times are coming, coming,
under the trees.
Hummin' fish are hummin', hummin',
under the trees.
Under the trees.
Oh, these glorious,
glimbimbulous,
splendorious,
splendibulous,
dandy, flandy, flimbulous,
truffula trees.
Those trees, those trees, those truffula trees. All my life I'd been searching for trees such as these. The touch of their tufts was much softer than silk, and they had the sweet smell of fresh butterfly milk. I felt a great leaping of love in my heart. I knew just what I'd do. I unloaded my car. In no time at all, I had built a small shop. Then I chopped down a truffula tree with one chop. What you doing in my tree stump, buddy?
Your tree stump? Your tree stump? Mister, I am the Lorax. I speak for the...
Forget it. I don't really need the stump. You can have it, little fellow. Enough to finish the cuffs.
A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Now, who'd you say you were, little fella?
Mister, I am the Lorax. I speak for the trees. I speak for the trees have no tongues. And I'm asking you, sir, at the top of my lungs, that thing, that horrible thing that I see, what's that thing you've made out of my truffula tree?
Look, Lorax, calm down. There's no cause for alarm. I chopped down just one tree. I'm doing no harm. This thing is most useful. This thing is a fine something that all people need. It's a shirt. It's a sock. It's a glove. It's a hat. But it has other uses. Yes, far beyond that. You can use it for carpets, for pillows, for sheets, or curtains, or covers for bicycle seats.
Sir, you're crazy. You're crazy with greed. Well, there's no one on earth who would buy that fool's need.
the birth of an industry, you poor stupid guy. You telling me what the public will buy?
Please, I object in the name of the trees.
All complaints will be filed in this box, if you please. Now I'd reached the stage where the potential was known. This business was too big for one onceler alone, so promptly I built me a radiophone. I called my brothers and uncles and aunts, and I said, listen here, here's a wonderful chance for the whole onceler family to get mighty rich. Get over here fast, take the road to North Niche, turn left at Weehawken, and sharp right at South Stitch.
Knocking, there'll be no more squawking.
We're gonna get rich,
filthy rich.
No more holes in our stocking. Turn left at Weehawken to the house of the glorious Onceler we go.
Gentlemen, I wish to speak for the trees. Here are some facts to cogitate and ruminate. It takes 10 months for a trophula seed to germinate. It takes 10 long years before the seed grows into a sapling. It takes 10 more years.
And in no time at all in the factory I built, the whole Onceler family was working full tilt. We were all knitting needs, just as busy as bees, to the sound of the chopping of trophula trees. Then. Oh, baby, oh, how my business did grow. Now chopping trees one at a time was too slow. So I promptly invented my super axe hacker, which whacked off 4 trophula trees in 1 smacker. We were making needs 4 times as fast as before, and my profits, incidentally, were soaring galore. Inadequate roadways. I want a 4-lane highway over there.
Instant Roadway Company at your service, sir.
Nobody listens too much, don't you know? I speak for the trees, and I'll yell and I'll shout for the fine things on earth that are on their way out. They say I'm old-fashioned and live in the past, but sometimes I think progress progresses too fast. They say I'm a fool to oppose things like these, but I'm going to continue to speak for the trees. I'm going to continue to speak for the trees. I'm going to continue to speak for the trees.
assembly line comes another theme, answering humanity's each and every need. Everybody do, 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 do need a need.
It isn't just a panty vest.
Use it for a hammock when you need rest.
It's a toothbrush holder for your weekend guest.
Your canary will love it. It's a lovely nest.
Try it in soup. It adds great zest.
It'll cure those backache pains in your chest.
Everybody do, 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 do need a need. You'll be amazed. You'll be nonplussed. It tastes like bread without the crust.
Grooms your hair when it gets must.
Rid your home of dismal dust.
It's a natural, it's a must.
Eliminates carburetor rust.
Everybody do, 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 do need a feed. It's super duper hooper hyper, makes a perfect windshield wiper, foolproof trap to catch a viper. We no complaints from any driver. Papa smokes a mini piper.
Baby says,
boy, what a diaper.
Everybody do, 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 do. Everybody do, 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 do. Everybody do, do, need a feed.
Heartwarming, very heartwarming.
Oh, place your hand upon your heart and recollect his humble start. He came here in a horse-drawn cart upon his sacred mission. Today the Onceler's fame has grown. Today the name of Fleet is known. It's carved in everlasting stone. Everlasting stone. And seen on television.
Huh? Oh, it's Nature Boy, the Garden Club member.
Now listen, all of you. I am the Lorax. I speak for the trees. Whoosh!
That was the Lorax. He spoke for the trees. Miss Funsler, Miss Funsler.
Yes, Mr. Wunsler?
Miss Funsler, send in Miss O'Schmunsler.
Miss O'Schmunsler.